As of Thursday morning, President Donald Trump said economic relief talks are back on. This after Trump abruptly declared Tuesday that talks for the new federal COVID-19 aid were over and ordered his White House deputies to stop negotiating with Democratic leaders, only to reverse his directive the very same day.
I was kind of really looking forward to getting another stimulus package. And yet, it's like we're a ping pong ball. We're just now a political ping pong ball.
Amy Bessa and her husband, chef Romy Duratan, are 25-year veterans of the New York restaurant business. Bessa said the COVID federal aid they got from the CARES Act a few months ago and being allowed to offer outdoor dining have helped them keep their restaurant, Purple Yam in Brooklyn, open amid the pandemic. Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell said he believes that unless the government supplied additional support, economic recovery is at risk.
Too little support would lead to a weak recovery, creating unnecessary hardship for households and businesses. Over time, household insolvencies and business bankruptcies would rise, harming the productive capacity of the economy and holding back wage growth.
You have to weigh, do I pay my rent late or do I buy food for the house? You know, that's how desperate the times are these days.
Joey Mayo is among millions of people in America who lost their jobs due to the pandemic. On Thursday, the Labor Department reported 11 million people continued to claim unemployment benefits.
I'm almost exhausted with the savings, like many people in my own shoes. I'm having to dip into credit to pay bills now.
Trump said COVID aid talks for piecemeal measures could include a new round of $1,200 stimulus checks for individuals. He said he would also sign standalone bills that would include a $1 billion bailout for the airline industry and more aid for small businesses. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi said Thursday she would reject any standalone bill and said a more comprehensive package should be passed. For those desperately needing help, there needs to be some sort of compromise soon.
I'm not a very religious person, but I am praying very hard to whoever listens that some kind of sanity goes back into the federal government and this stimulus really goes back to all the businesses and to all the people that are so much in need.
Lenn Almadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.